Hello, this is John Locke from Lockedown Design. Today I want to talk with you for just a few minutes about 301 redirects, what they are, and why you need to implement them on your website properly. To start things off, redirects are a way that you can have one web address go to another one, and this is especially useful if you're changing the web address of a page. Let's say if you're changing the address of your about page from about us to about. So what redirects do is, if you have that URL somewhere else on the web built out as a link, or if you sent it to somebody in an email, or if it's in a Facebook post, instead of them hitting a page where it says file not found, page not found, 404, they're going to end up on the page that you want them to end up on. In plainest language, a redirect takes you from one URL to the URL that you've changed that to. And when I say URL, that just means the web address. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. It just means the web address that you've typed in. So why are redirects important? And what type of redirect should you be using? You should pretty much always be using a 301 redirect, and that means that it's a permanent redirect. You've permanently changed that web address from what it was before to what it is now. There's another type of redirect called a 302, which is a temporary redirect. You really don't want to use these for SEO reasons. Google does not look at 302 redirects in the same way that they look at 301s. 301s pass any link equity that you get from building a backlink on another site back to your site. Reasons why you might change a web address from one thing to another. One, you might be building your site on a new platform. A lot of websites, they might be built out in flat HTML files. They might be built out in PHP or on Cold Fusion. .cfm, or they might be built on .net, any sort of thing, and you might be moving it to a different type of platform. A lot of the sites that we build are on WordPress, so if you had a site that was built where the web addresses all end in .html, and you move it to something like WordPress or Drupal or some other type of platform, you would want to do 301 redirects for all your old URLs to the new web addresses, and that's because Google will still try and crawl them, and it's very likely that you have backlinks out there on the web that have already been built with those old web addresses. You want them, when people click on that, to go to the corresponding web address on your new website. Another reason that you might need 301 redirects is if you are simply shortening the web addresses on the pages on your site. A lot of the sites that we look at, they might have web addresses that are not descriptive of what's on that page, and so changing those web addresses might be a good idea. Sometimes as well, you might have very long web addresses for each page on your website. That's not really beneficial for your users. It's not beneficial for search engines. And this is several years ago, so take it with a grain of salt, but Google has said that they kind of ignore everything past, you know, 12 words in your web address. So if you have ones that are super, super long, it's really not benefiting anyone. So shortening them up and making them a little bit more clear is a good idea. Another reason that you might want to change the web addresses on your site is that you're repeating stuff. If you're targeting different locations, such as different cities or regions, and you're repeating the city in a couple places, you might want to clean that up. The important thing to do is to make sure that you have 301 redirects in place anytime that you're changing a web address on your site. There's different ways that you can do that. Most sites, you can go into what's called the htaccess file. Most sites might have one, or you can create one on your hosting. You can do redirects one by one there. If you're on a WordPress site, you can use a plugin such as redirection to create 301 redirects for any URLs that you have changed. The important thing to do is just make sure anytime that you're changing a web address on your site, make sure that you have redirects in place for that page, because it won't just happen on its own. So that is what 301 redirects are. That might be a little confusing for some of you, but just realize, if you're building a brand new site and you're moving that site to another platform, you're going to want to have a plan for 301 redirects, or if you're changing web addresses, URLs on your site, that you're going to want to have a plan for redirecting. If you have an SEO question that you'd like to see us answer, go ahead and leave it in the comments below. Again, I'm John Locke for Lockedown Design. We do SEO for manufacturing, industrial, and blue-collar companies. Don't forget to subscribe. Okay, so...